Welcome back to XCOM 2. Let's close that window and pretend, well, I can't really pretend that didn't happen, but yeah, we have four people to, we owe it to those four people to keep on pushing forward. That's Takahashi, Ivana, Ramirez, and of course, Samuel Sly. They all fell. Partially in due to my mistakes, of course, but they fell in the defense of both XCOM and humanity. So, once again, farewell to them, but we gotta continue on. So we do have a lot of wounded. This is another thing I was thinking about. Sindri is still fine, because he's crazy like that. And, Jabir's okay. Good. But I think we might be taking a few squaddies along for the next mission. So, I mean, we're not in too dire of straits. Next thing I should be looking at is the Guerrilla Tactics School. I believe six squad members requires a captain, correct? Okay. So, who is close to captain? Two people that are wounded. Stefania will be coming back soon. I don't know how close she is to captain, but, I mean, getting her kills is not that hard. She's the one who usually executes people with combat protocol anyways, so that's cool. And, Mateus is still gonna be gone for a while, buddy. Even with our Advanced Warfare Center up, though. But, hey, it's huge. It's getting our stronger guys back in the field as soon as possible. Huge. So, four engineers hard at work. What is it, two scientists or three scientists, maybe? Hard at research. I think we stick with our initial plan of...
Having destroyed the Black Site,
yes.
You have dealt a blow to the alien operations, Commander. But there is still no time to lose.
No, let me, no, calm down, elusive, I mean, not elusive man, spokesman. We'll be fine, maybe. Two people back from the infirmary, and supply drop.
Got an urgent communication coming in for you now, Commander.
Put it on through.
You have made considerable progress against the aliens over the past month,
That's
Commander.
Cool.
I hope that your ongoing efforts will only lead to further success.
Hey, I hope the same too. June 14th, 2035. I would say that's a pretty successful week, all things considered. Minor breakthrough needs to be countered. Alloy padding, I don't really care about this. That's not the worst thing in the world. And hidden event, I'm not going to spend intel on that because we are so limited for what I want to be doing right now that... Nah. So, supply drops. What do I need to buy right now that requires supplies? Nothing, I feel like.
Long live the resistance.
New Chile, sweet.
New regional contacts located.
That's fine. Now there, New Australia, that's what I need to get to. We need to go see the kangaroos. 5 to 7 days, 100 supplies. We might as well. I mean, this will reduce the intel contact cost of going over to New Australia, and we were kind of in a rush, but not at the same time. Oh man, plated armor is coming up in... quicker than I thought it would
be. Reading you loud and clear.
Next. We should probably get the supplies. Get the supply drop. Because I don't know. I think it just stays there forever. But I'm not certain. And I don't really want to lose 379
Avenger
supplies.
New course.
So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Maybe this is, you know, just a tactical error. Well, not a strategic error, let's say. But... yeah, let's grab our supplies, and then we could do whatever. We're probably gonna get a mission now anyways. Now then. What kind of mission are we going to get? This is minor breakthrough, right? Okay, I want to do that because I don't need an extra block of progress being added to the Avatar project. 105 intel. That's nice. We need a specialist for this. Operation Mountain King.
Setting course for Sector 11, West Africa.
I would make a lot of references to Lion King right now, but I unfortunately don't remember a lot of them. So I can't. But oh well. Sindri up in front. Yep, you sir are definitely coming along. Galena. I guess both of our lieutenants can come along. If they get captain on this mission, all the better. The squad that's picked out right on the screen is actually our highest, well, it's not a bad squad, in addition to being our highest ranked soldiers, of course. I'm gonna go with Thin Man, just because I want to start leveling him up. And Tamara is cool, of course. But instead of Tamara, or rather, well, we definitely need a specialist, so Stefania is definitely coming along. I could not take, and I don't want to do this because she's been doing so well, and she does a lot of killing, which I like killing. And I don't entirely trust anyone else to be doing the killing right now. But we won't have a scout. Will that be problematic? I mean, it might be. I shouldn't mess around with this, but you know what? I am. Is our other shinobi dead? Oh, wait, no. They're both here. Okay. Yeah, what kind of perks do you have, Loke? Untouchable. Right, we could just have him as pretty much an offensive unit anyways. A shardgun, Hunter's Axe. Yeah, I like this for him. I totally forgot we had the gas grenade. Now, whose aim do I actually want to increase? Thin Man? No. Sindri, maybe. But Sindri already has the perk that, I mean, his aim's not bad by itself. Oh gosh, I mean, I think it's gonna be Tamara. If I get her into an elevation bonus, position rather. The bonus from elevation is already really good because of damn good ground, but, I mean, without it, I guess we could have this to fall back on. So, yep, that goes to Tamara. Snipers, man. Really good. So, yeah, Tamara is pretty much locked and loaded. We're gonna leave the dragon rounds with her. We could scout with Lee, for the most part. And, what? I'm not gonna do anything with damage control yet, because I don't actually know what that is. Ramirez is fully upgraded. Schmidt will get the bolt caster. All soldiers not currently, okay. I was mainly reading that just so it's like, oh, make all weapons available except for the current soldier selected. So it's like, oh, I will have to redo all my weapon selections now. But thankfully I don't need to, and it doesn't do that. Because that would be really annoying, but it's not that bad. Mm. Do I have a not standard shard gun? Oh, this is a not standard shard gun. And shotgun for that matter, but yeah, I think we just go ahead and do this. Once again, I want someone with a flashbang. Who is gonna get a flashbang? Didn't man? I could, well, gas grenades don't destroy cover, do they? I don't know. Let's give him the gas grenade to just experiment with. And I guess Schmidt, you get the flashbang. Well, we don't need a flash. She'll have two flashbangs then. Whatever. No medkit, as usual. Should be okay, I think. Or maybe we give Schmidt a medkit. Question. Yeah, let's do that. We should be able to work with one flashbang, I think. I mean, I hope so, because we're doing this. So yeah. Hack the hidden resistance computer before it's hit found by Advent. Let's begin. It's funny that each soldier, I mean, this is actually a step above XCOM 1, where soldiers really didn't have a lot of loadout stuff to do, as I remember anyways. And XCOM 1, I mean enemy within, or enemy unknown for that matter, but a lot of the loadout stuff, quote unquote, was mainly research.
Resistance operatives managed to hack into the Advent network through an exposed access point in this area, but alien reinforcements made quick work of it.
And there was an aerial
report indicated they
jet
may have found something
airbase
critical
element
to the aliens later
to that as well.
We'll need to secure the area and hack the terminal before Advent has time to shut down the connection. Eliminate all hostiles with extreme prejudice. This is our chance to stop their progress.
The slums district, Mud Alley, Ibadan. Yeah, it has to be Ibadan. This is Operation Mountain King. Let us deploy. Let's fly right through that building and crash and die. I don't know why it looks like that on this tile set specifically. You know, maybe just a building spawns there?
Menace 1-5, this is Avenger. The access point we're after is just ahead. Move to secure the area. Expect hostile resistance.
8 turns. Lovely. We have some good... This building that's right of us, I would love to get Tamara on there because she has line of sight on the building that we want to be fighting around. So that's my first objective, per se.
Roger that.
Loke, move forward. Scout out everything.
Enemy sighted.
Oh. Well... Maybe not, then.
Begebe mich zur Zielposition.
I could move her right here, because we'll be fighting in that building.
Good to go.
And then just get ready to fight right now. I mean, the sooner we wipe these guys out, the sooner we don't have to worry about them. We have I don't remember them having that much health, but we have an Advent Shield Bearer there. So that'll be fun to work with.
I am the harbinger of your ascendance.
We should be getting people into position as soon as possible. I think this isn't a bad position. Thin Man's here to blow their cover. Everyone else is here to take shots. We're not gonna take a shot right now, but yeah. On the next turn, provided they don't move away.
Gotta cover. I'm on it.
Scanner gebiet.
I'm hoping they move out more toward... Oh god, they're moving away. Great. But not too far away. I mean, they barely moved at all, actually. So, that works out. I'm thinking of suppressing in with Sentry. With Sentry. Not Sentry. That won't really help her aim because it's already at 100%. Um,
We are your destiny.
If I do that, I'm gonna move Loke here. So we could have Tamar on Overwatch. Sentry is not on Overwatch, he's on suppression duty, but they're gonna move, so he's basically taking a shot anyways. Thin Man, did I left you with a shard gun accidentally? Damn it. Okay, that's not good. That's not great at all. But the good thing about this is Sentry will be able to put holo targeting on them, so he should get a decent shot off. This tile set is very familiar from earlier in our playthrough, I think. I'm just gonna do nothing with Thin Man, at least.
Got it covered.
Not nothing in general. So Stefania, I'd love you to hit. Really would love that. And I'd say the Muton is the higher priority until the Shield Bearer gets his shield up. Because I don't think we could take the Shield Bearer out that quickly. Three are suppressed. Three will get shot. Nice thing about this is they're going to move up. Break suppression. They have holo targeting on us still. Yeah, nice shot, Sentry. Yes, love it. Fill that guy full of lead. 100% shot coming in. Good, that was good.
Target neutralized.
Now, we have a flank on this guy, the Shield Bearer, so I could just take him out right now if I throw the axe in, and I think I'm gonna do that. Let's guarantee a kill while we can, huh?
They've seen me.
Yep, they've seen me, alright. But that's okay. Yikes.
That's how it's done. Something.
Last but not least, Thin Man. I'm just gonna go into Overwatch. Everyone is behind. What's that? Oh, Thin Man, come on. Darn, oh well. If I gave him a rifle, that maybe would have hit. I see another group up ahead. Okay. So that's fun to work with.
Moving to position.
We could have Tamara ready her weapon to just fire, but right now they're in a pretty good position to, well, yes, engage them, but also, can I get through the, can I get this through the wall?
Hang out.
Oh, okay, wait, no, he's not spotted. Okay, good. Impact fields. Whoa. That's some cool stuff.
Asset secure.
But of course, they spotted us. Never mind. Okay, this is worse than I thought. Well, maybe not, actually. We'll figure something out. Sentry has the Mimic Beacon. Thin Man here. I could move in and gas them. Well, not really, because they're too far away, but lovely. Lovely. Yeah, I think Mimic Beacon it is, then we can just clean them up after this. Because I'm not seeing any really good anything. So, reload, and everyone just overwatches except for Sentry, who tosses the Mimic Beacon over to preferably high cover, so right here. Everyone should have line of sight on that, so they should go for him. Everyone else, overwatch. As they come in, we'll take shots. What? Oh, okay, for a second I thought he actually shot at a XCOM soldier. Wow, Thin Man. I don't care if that's a dodge, that's a good hit. Not quite a good hit there, Loke.
Missed the target.
Adjust your aim very slightly. Oh,
convenient.
Shot through that pillar, and just like I like to imagine it just like pierced through the pillar and shot him. Just like this incredibly brutal image, I guess. Alright. Not 100% shots all around. So good. You are. So if Sentry moves over here, I'm not really worried about detecting people now. Or 58%. Free reload? Don't take a free reload, just shoot. You hit? You hit, wow. Okay, man, everyone's showing Galena up. Now I think 52% even with, but that's not too bad considering he's under heavy cover. Yeah, it's not terrible. I say we start off with Stefania. 52%. Good enough. Good enough. And let's just bring it in with this Naja kill. 100% means they cannot dodge. That was added in the patch after release, and I think it's awesome. So let's see. This will be a kill no matter what. Yikes, buddy. That camera angle was cool. Next, we'll just move in and just overwatch. No reason to rush too much. Did I say rushed? Whatever.
Moving out.
Now, did this activate them? This did activate them, okay. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Okay, that's actually kind of bad. Maybe. We have a grenade that we could blow up the Sidewinder's cover with and then just take him out, assuming the thin man hits him. I think this is our best bet here. So, Loke, grenade out. Thank you. Now, thin man. Jesus, okay, that's a worse chance to hit than before. Or we could fall back, not to heavy cover, but to cover nonetheless. God, I could poison him. Can I poison both him and the sectoid? If I could, that'd be ideal. I mean, if I can't, whatever. Jeez, okay, this is... I presume, yeah, they can flank us. Specifically, that bastard in the building can. 74%, please hit. Oh, thank goodness.
Hostile neutralized.
Promotion earned. Now, we're not immune to flanking still, is the problem. Like this, for example. Oh god. Damn it! Ah, shoot. Okay, falling back was the better idea. Damn! I shouldn't have... I didn't know if they were active yet or not. I really didn't. Well. So, we don't have a grenadier now. Damn, that was crappy. The sectoid, 37%. Give a shot on the side zombie. But he can move in and have a shot on the sector, though, so that's not terrible.
They will be as we are.
Nice. Okay, good. I would love to fletch in, but that's really risky. That's real risky.
Not a problem.
Overwatch, just in case he decides to move. And then... I guess tomorrow, Overwatch as well. Damn, I cannot believe that. Half cover's not a bad shot, so... Oh well.
Shot wide.
Really? What's going on here? Okay. I thought he was gonna flank
these
somebody
again. Menace 1-5,
the Advent network is almost entirely locked down. We're running out of time. Get to that terminal.
So, okay, shoot. We just have to open the door and then we should be fine. If I move here... I mean, 55% is not a bad shot either. That's okay. I could kill him with the bolt caster, but I kind of don't want to do that, actually.
On my way.
So, Loke, flank him and kill him, please. 95%. That's a kill, alright. Huh.
Only the best.
Alright.
Draining ammo fast!
Damn. I don't know if we're safe to move up further. Did Thin Man have anything essential? I don't know. Not the bolt caster, obviously. And he can't have axes, so no.
Let's do this!
Damn, I can't believe I lost
Scanning.
Him. Ah, Jesus. It's rough. I could move here if I don't have line of sight of the computer thing.
Commander, we have confirmation of the
what
exposed access point.
Well, I have an idea. It's this. Oh god. Wait, were those just
Absolutely.
Civilians? Does it show me what they are? I presume those are just civilians then. Tomorrow move here. Just so you have a better angle and then steady aim. And Loke, do the same thing.
Ready to engage.
We should be okay. I think.
Menace 1-5, the Advent network terminal is shutting down. This is your last chance to secure the data.
Yeah, we should be okay. I didn't see anyone inside the building with the scan, so... I'm just gonna assume that there's no one inside the building. So good, you could go through windows, it seems. This is cool. I like this. Enemy protocol. Love it. Take it. Yep, I'll take that. Hacking staff permanently increased by 20. That's basically the same as upgrading upgrading the gremlin.
Successful acquisition of the Advent file.
So they're up
Eliminate
ahead.
Any remaining
Lovely.
Hostiles in the area.
Not a problem.
Heading out.
Oh, why did I move her? Well, maybe that's not the best idea. I mean, the worst idea.
We fight
Overwatch.
As one.
Moving to Overwatch.
Feind ist in Bewegung.
do we got here? Well, good. I like having overwatch shots on them. What is that? One drone, one officer, and what, oh, it's a shield bearer, okay. The shield bearer's gonna get shot. Now here's where we can just go all out on them. Because there's very reason to not. I mean, very little reason to not. I could suppress either or.
Attack.
And they can't do much with that suppression. Or I could go for the flanking shot. Yeah, I say flanking shot. Is that a kill? Oh, he's not dead. Okay, that's fine. Is that just fine? Because I think Tamara might be able to kill him now. 50. Ah, well, try it. Wow.
Target
I just
eliminated.
Forced the door open. Okay. If you fletch in, that's not the greatest idea in the world, but it's not a bad idea either. I don't see much of a value in moving from here. So, I don't think I am going to move from here. If I go over here and take a shot, apparently I still have line of sight. And this will prevent flanking. Which I will be trying to prevent, like, the plague now. Good hit.
Rüstung hält stand.
74. Nah. If I'm willing to do that and it hits, it'll kill him. But there's also does Loke have untouchable? I don't know. I'm gonna presume he does. Yeah, I know he's killed someone already. So let's make sure I know how this works. Okay, yep. I mean, he should basically be invincible, and this should be the last enemy group on the map. So whatever.
Hard target, minimal damage.
Like, there's two options that you have here, which is this. I'm not really concerned about this. And the other is having the drone break untouchable. Now, let's see if this actually untouchable counters this. Apparently, it does not. But still, that's okay. Because if you shoot at him, you're just gonna miss. Okay, Sindri, I need you to do your thing. Half cover is fine. Moving over here, also fine. Everything is fine. Yeah, so it did spot civilians earlier. 45%, all I really want is... Well...
Your form is fragile.
He did survive, didn't he? Okay, 82%, there we go. That is more like it. Damn.
Not good.
No, that's still okay. Well, I need to get line of sight of him, apparently, but we could finish him off with a combat protocol. And then we just have this drone doing whatever it wants to do, but I'm not too worried about that. Now, what is the drone capable of, I wonder? It's stunning again, so that seems like that's what it does.
Feinde greifen von den Seiten an.
Yikes. Okay. How about we just shoot it? That was okay, yes. Perfectly fine.
An annoyance.
And this should kill it. Pretty well. That's an overkill shot on a drone like that.
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure.
Status
confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Lost Thin Man. Damn. I was hoping we would get lucky. I should have fallen back. But the best thing I could have done there, or I should have done, is just not move up. Since I knew a group was there, but for some reason I thought they were already active, so they wouldn't, you know, get their little spread out bonus. Not really a bonus, but they wouldn't do their spread out thing, which of course, since they put themselves in a good position, they could follow, they were able to follow up with that really well. So I shouldn't have done that at all. I should have just not moved up, even if we were on a time limit. Because losing troops is basically just as bad as failing a mission, almost. But I mean, at the same time, we have a dark event countered, so the Avatar project is slowed. But yeah. Yeah, I just should have been more careful. No promotions. And the Thin Man's gone. Sucks.
Hello, Commander.
But at least we have that.
Commander, if you come across anyone with an aptitude for the sciences, send them my way. I could use the help.
Low on scientists. Whatever. So, poor Thin Man. The fifth. And the second squatty. Yeah. Soldier epitaph. What should I write here? I guess, fought on the side of righteousness. And he did. So he'll be honored just like any XCOM soldier would be. So we lost our Thin Man. Here's Sindri in the bar. And with Bradford too, it seems. Bradford came to see the Thin Man. I guess he couldn't believe that the Thin Man's gone too. I couldn't. So yeah. We'll pick up here on the next episode. But again, thank you for watching. This is Krendis, and I'll see you soon.